Hi, I'm Peter Adamson, and this is a special and long-awaited announcement about the History of Philosophy podcast. Ever since I began the series, I've been receiving questions and feedback from listeners, and by far the most frequent comment was that I should really be covering philosophy beyond the traditions that came out of ancient Greece. I should look not just at European philosophy and philosophy in the Islamic world, but also philosophy in India and China. Well, I'm finally doing it. This weekend, instead of an episode on medieval philosophy, I'm releasing the first of a substantial series of episodes on philosophy in classical India. These episodes are being co-authored with an expert on the subject, Janardan Ganeri of New York University. To download them, you'll need to seek out a separate podcast feed. You should be able to find it through iTunes or any other podcasting software. This is just to keep the narrative on India separate from the series on medieval philosophy, which will be continuing to appear in alternate weeks with the episodes on India. So the next installment of medieval philosophy will appear next weekend. Of course, the episodes on Indian philosophy will also be available to stream or download on the website www.historyofphilosophy.net, which will also have links to the new podcast feed. While I have your attention, let me share with you a couple of other exciting announcements. First, the second volume in the series of books based on the podcast has been published. It's called Philosophy in the Hellenistic and Roman Worlds. You can get it from Oxford University Press, just like the first volume on classical philosophy. The new volume takes the story from the Hellenistic schools, the Stoics, Skeptics, and Epicureans, down through late antiquity, with the rise of Neoplatonism and philosophy among late ancient Christians. Though it is based on the podcast scripts, there is added material, with new chapters on Galen and on later ancient economics, in which I cover philosophers' ideas about money-making, slavery, and the role of women in the household and in political life. You can expect the third volume, on philosophy in the Islamic world, to appear in 2016. But if you can't wait for that, then also from Oxford University Press, you can also get another book I've just published called Philosophy in the Islamic World, A Very Short Introduction. Whereas the podcast books are arranged chronologically and move through history figure by figure, this short introduction is arranged thematically, so it will give you a quick overview of the philosophical issues that arose among Muslim, Jewish, and Christian thinkers living in the realms of Islam from the beginnings in the 8th century all the way down to the 20th century. And, by the way, it's very cheap and very short. If you're in southern England at the beginning of November, you can join me for a launch of both books at Blackwell's Bookshop in Oxford, which is part of the OUP Philosophy Festival, taking place 2nd to 7th November. For your chance to win tickets to this event, email your name, location, and contact details to withoutanygaps@oup.com. So that email address again is withoutanygaps, as one word, @oup.com. I'll also post information about this on the podcast Twitter feed, the Facebook page, and the website. And while I still have your attention, one final announcement. Incredibly, episode 250 of the podcast is coming up. Instead of the traditional double interview like the ones I did for episodes 50, 100, 150, and 200, I thought I would devote episode 250 to answering questions from you, the podcast listeners. So, if you want to know anything about the history of philosophy, especially anything relating to ancient or medieval philosophy, which is what I've covered so far, or about the exciting life of a philosophy podcaster, then get in your questions on the website, or find the podcast on Twitter or Facebook and leave a comment. I'll do my best to answer as many questions as come in. But you don't need to pose that most frequently asked question as to whether I'm ever going to cover Indian philosophy, since you know the answer to that already. I sure am, starting this very weekend. And, by the way, I hope to go on to devote future series of podcasts to philosophy in other cultures like Africa and China. Thanks for listening.